Hi, Scott Gorsester from Moose Logic. I'm a senior computer engineer here, and today we're going to talk a little bit about backups and show you a demonstration of Microsoft System Center Data Protection Manager 2010. Last couple of years, we've really been looking for a better way to back up our data and also make recommendations to our customers to back up their data. And so what we've come across is the System Center Data Protection Manager product. We started working with this product in the 2007 release, and quite frankly, we're very impressed with it. And the reasons we're impressed with it is it's very easy to use. It offers us short-term and long-term backups, so we're able to have our short-term backups in an online disk pool on hard drive, very, very fast to create backups and to recover backups. And then we also have a mechanism within this product to do long-term storage to tape. And we're able to use actual tape devices, or in our case, we use hard disks attached to our network, so network-attached storage, and we configure those with a product called FireStreamer to emulate tape. So ultimately, we're still writing in a tape format, but we're saving on hard drives. So we get the basically the advantage of high-speed reads and writes and low-cost storage for our long-term backups. We'll go ahead and take a look at our interface now, and we'll bring up the System Center Data Protection Manager Management Console. Just take a few minutes to bring that up on our Data Protection Manager server. And this product, once it comes up, you'll see that we have five tabs, if you will, on our toolbar. That is monitoring, protection, recovery, reporting, and management. And that's really the five categories that we would work with on our Data Protection Manager server. And then within those, we may see some additional tabs for additional interfaces. Under the Protection tab, we see our protection groups. Now, in this particular product, we call them protection groups. You might otherwise refer to these as backup sets. And so in this particular interface, we're able to see what's going on with our protection groups. In other words, look whether we have green lights on our protection groups or a red X. We have a red X on one of them, so there's one problem that we need to address. And then we also can create new protection groups, delete existing protection groups, or edit or modify the existing groups. And so if we want to add new folders or new data or remove some data from a protection group, it's easy to do in this particular screen. The other important tab here, well, they're all important, but another interesting tab is the management tab. And this really is where we manage our Data Protection Manager agents, our online storage for our short-term backups, and our long-term storage to basically tape libraries, even though in this case I'm using hard drives as our tapes. Under the agents tab, we're able to install agents to machines. We can actually push them from the Data Protection Manager server. We're able to see the status of the existing machines. We are able to change some of the behavior of agents, whether we use compression and those kinds of things. We're also able to disable and or uninstall these agents. Under the disk tab is where we would manage the onboard drives for long-term storage. We call this the online pool. And as you can see, I have three 1.5 terabyte drives that are displayed here. Is just a little under 1.4 terabytes due to overhead. This gives us about 4.2 or 4.3 terabytes of storage using low-cost SATA drives on our Data Protection Manager server. Currently in our own production server, we have about 458 gigs of data stored. And so we have lots of capacity if we want to increase the amount of time we keep our short-term backups. Right now we keep them about 2 weeks. We can go to a month if we like. Or if we want to include more data in those backups, we have plenty of storage available to do that. On the Libraries tab is basically where we would configure and manage our tape libraries. What you see here shows as a FireStreamer library. That means we're using, again, FireStreamer to prepare NAS devices. These can be Ethernet attached or network attached hard disks. They can be hard disks attached directly to the Data Protection Manager server, or they can be tape devices attached directly to the Data Protection Manager server as well. So tape library or simply a single tape would be sufficient for us to write long-term backups in this particular case. Under the Recovery tab is obviously where we can search for and recover the data that we've backed up. And it's a very nice and very intuitive interface. As you can see, we have all of our protected or what we would call recoverable data listed on the left pane. And then we also have a calendar here. So as we drill down on the protected data, in other words, this is displayed here as our servers and the folders we're protecting. And let's say we pick on a particular folder, we actually see all the points back in time. And we have basically data here back to the beginning of this month, about 3 weeks of data that's recoverable. And if we go back far enough, we'll see that we need to recover that from tape. So if we now drill down on that, it tells us that we have to read the tapes to determine. So we're going to read the database to find out what tape this data is stored on. And then the Data Protection Manager will tell us what tape we need to load to make sure we're able to recover that data. If we go to an earlier point in time, we'll see that we can recover this from disk. And that's going to be on the online pool. So essentially, we can easily recover this data. When we attempt to recover the data, we can choose where we would like to recover it to. So we can select a recovery type, we can select our options, our summary, and the status, and we can choose a location to recover that to. So we can put it on our local hard drive here, or right on the Data Protection Manager server, or recover it to the original source as well. It's also a very rich reporting tool, and that leverages SQL reporting services and basically offers us a number of reports that we can run to see what's been going on our Data Protection Manager server. So that's the quick tour today. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you take a longer look at this product. We've been very happy with it, and this product has saved the day for us on our own network and for our customers a number of times now. Thank you.